In this activity, you're going to create a simple circuit using a breadboard, an LED, a resistor, and 4 AA batteries. Okay, so I've gone ahead and trimmed the legs off my resistor. You can see I have a resistor here. If you have some wire cutters, strippers, you can cut those, trim those up. Or if you have an old pair of scissors that you don't care about anymore, you could also use those. So the way a breadboard works is you have rows and you have columns in which are electrically connected. So you can see a plus sign here, and this column of nodes is all connected. Also here you have a negative sign, and this line, a column of nodes, is all connected as well. Then in the middle here, where you have the A, B, C, D, E, that row number one, all those nodes are connected. So anything attached to any of the 5 nodes in row one are electrically connected. That would be one node on an electrical schematic. And then on the sides here, on the rails we call them, for this positive side, anything connected on this entire first column of dots or nodes is electrically connected. So that would be a single connected point on an electrical schematic. Okay, so to build this, we're gonna place one resistor across here. We're going to use our LED. You'll notice this LED has a small and a large leg. The small leg is the negative polarity. The large leg is the positive polarity. It is important that you make note of the polarity before you put this in. Okay, so we are gonna put the negative side into row 4, which is what our resistor's in. The resistor direction does not matter. Resistors function in both ways, the exact same resistance, so we don't have to worry about anything here. But the diode, the LED, does not. So we do have to pay careful attention to that. So we're gonna have the negative, or the negative polarity lead in row 4, positive polarity lead on row 5. Now I have my batteries already assembled. Polarities are all in the correct order. I'm gonna connect the negative lead to row 4 over here. On this side, my positive lead to this side. Okay, and you can see that the LED light turns on. So, this is a great video just to check your ability to use a breadboard correctly and to use a resistor, an LED. Okay, so the next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna measure the current of this simple circuit. So in order to do that, first of all, we wanna make sure our circuit works. So let's confirm that everything's working. All right, everything looks good. So now we need to break the circuit and put our meter in series with the circuit. So I'm gonna connect the negative polarity here. And the positive polarity, or the red probe, I'm gonna connect to my, let's see, maybe disconnect it there. There we go. Okay, so I am measuring 2.42 milliamps.